Hello everyone, welcome to AlloGris. In this video, I will demonstrate how to create a bot to read your Outlook emails. Go to UiPath Studio, click on the new process, name the process Outlook Read Emails and provide the description as the demo is about how to read emails from your Outlook account. Click Create button. Click on Open Main Workflow on your Project Workflow Designer panel. Go to the Activity panel and search Outlook Activity. A couple of Outlook actions will be noticed here. We will go through them one by one. I will show you how to read emails from your Outlook inbox in this tutorial. For that, add the Outlook mail messages into the Workflow Designer panel. Get Outlook mail messages. Retrieves email messages from Outlook. Go to the property panel. Look at the properties of Get Outlook mail messages. Account. The account is used to access the messages that are to be retrieved. For example, if you have multiple user accounts in Outlook, specify which account you want to retrieve messages from. Mail folder. The mail folder from which the messages are to be retrieved. For example, you have an inbox, draft, send item, and other custom folders. Specify which folder you want to retrieve messages from within double quotes. Here is the default folder is inbox, which the messages to be retrieved. Filter. A string used as a filter for the messages to be retrieved. It accepts jQuery or DASL queries. We will see all the filter methods, how it works in the next tutorial. Filter by message IDs. Filter by message IDs. Only mail messages with the specified message IDs are returned. Mark as read. When this option is selected, all retrieved messages are marked as read in the email folder. Only unread messages. When you select this option, the bot will only retrieve unread messages from your folder. This checkbox is selected by default. Order by date. When you choose this option, the retrieved messages are sorted by day in the mail. Newest first and oldest first are the two options available. Top. The number of messages to be retrieved starting from either the newest or the oldest depending on the order by date input. Make sure that if this field is empty, the activity returns no messages. Finally, I am moving to the output property. Messages. The messages variable will be retrieved messages as a collection of mail message object. Let's start designing the process. Go to property panel. In the output message field, press Ctrl K to create a variable. I will name the variable as my mail messages and enter. Then click OK. Now I want to read all the emails based on the settings in the Get Outlook mail messages property panel. I will use for each activity to iterate all the emails one by one. For each activity, the for each activity enables you to step through arrays, lists, data tables, or other types of collections so that you can iterate through the data and process each piece of information individually. If you see the variable messages type list, click on for each and go to property panel, select type argument. The default type argument is object. You need to convert it to system.get.mail.mailMessage to get the subject, mail body, sender address, to address, receive date, and so on. Select browse to select type argument. In the search box, type system.net.mail.mailMessage. Select and click OK. In the value field of for each activity, call the variable myMailMessage. Now, I want to store the subject of the retrieved email. Add an assign activity into for each activity and name the activity. Create a variable str subject in the to field. In the value field, call the item, then add a dot. Now you will see all the mail property. I will select subject to retrieve my email subject and click OK. To display the result, add the message box or write line activity and call the variable strSubject. Followed by, I will add a few more assign activity to see few property of retrieved email. Email body, sender address, to address. Check your emails before you run the process. I have 200 emails for the process. Now all set to go. Run the process. The bot is started executing. You see the message box displaying the subject from the first retrieved email. Click OK and you will see the message box displaying the body of the first retrieved email. Click OK. You will see the next message box displaying the sender address. Click OK. And again you will see the next result is the message box displaying the to address of the first retrieved email. From here, you can start building your automation using if condition activity to apply your logic to identify the mail or the attachment or the sender email based on your process need. Thank you for watching. Connect with us for more tutorials.